subscribe to my channel. Hey guys, what's up? It's Poonam here and welcome to my channel. And if you guys are new to this channel, then make sure you subscribe to this channel and hit the bell notification so that you are notified whenever I post a new video. Now, I am really excited for today's video because this video is a bit different than my usual nail art videos because I usually prefer behind the camera. And since I'm here in Bengaluru, so I thought I should share my experience with you guys. Before getting into the video, now let me tell you that I am basically from Mumbai and I usually travel to Bengaluru because of my work purpose. So since I'm here in Bengaluru, I thought I should give you an insight about my experience because I have observed a major difference between these two cities. So if you guys like this video, then give this video a huge thumbs up and let me know if you guys could relate to it. So let's get started. Now, the first thing that I would like to talk about is the climate here in Bengaluru. Although it's the month of April, but you won't feel like the summer has already started. Now, let me tell you why I told you. Because one, you don't sweat, and second, you don't get tan. Because I hope you understand what I mean to say. Because summers are hell hot in Mumbai and you can't survive without an AC and you can't leave your house without the scarf, umbrella or the gloves. Now the next thing that I'm crazy about is the greenery that Bengaluru has got. I mean, wow, when I see those big trees with different shades of green and tiny little flowers, it definitely makes my day. No doubt that it is regarded as the green city. The next most important thing that I would like to talk about is the transport facility that helps us to stay connected. Now, I would say that the transport facility in Bengaluru is not as good as in Mumbai because Mumbai has definitely got the best transport facilities like the autos, buses, trains and metro. It runs 24/7 and are consistent and frequent, except that they are overcrowded and people run like crazy. They run as if they are in a marathon. It is crazy sometimes, but it is funny at the same time. So while Bengaluru has got a metro which is quite well maintained, but I am not a fan of the buses that run here. The Volvo buses are huge and bulky. Now, one interesting thing that I found is the outfit of the traffic police officer or the police officer. They have got a cute cowboy style hat which is quite interesting and it looks cute. Now, speaking of the traffic, it is similar, like both the cities have got the same traffic. And obviously, how can I forget the auto walas? Auto walas in Mumbai are well disciplined and they use meter, and moreover you have sharing autos as well. Whereas in Bengaluru, I have never seen an auto wala using meter, and if they get to know that you're not from Bengaluru, then they charge you like anything. Like they start the price range from 150 to 200 and that too just for a shorter distance, which is hardly like 15 to 20 minutes away. Because my experience with the auto walas was literally not good. So I usually prefer Ola auto in this case if I need to travel to shorter distance here in Bengaluru. That is definitely a best option if you are here in Bengaluru. Now the next thing that I'll talk about is the food. Now before I start, let me tell you that I'm not a foodie person nor a coffee lover. Now why I told you, because I see so many CCDs here in Bengaluru and it looks like as if the Bengalurians are coffee lover, but I'm not sure about it. Let me know in the comment section below. Although I love idli and dosa, which is the speciality of South India, but I definitely miss vada pav. Now let's talk about the safety. All I would say is Mumbai is a lot safer than Bengaluru because Mumbai has got a better nightlife, plus Mumbai never sleeps. Whereas in Bengaluru, you can't step outside your house or hotel after 10 o'clock. It becomes too risky and you won't find any shops or the restaurant open. Now, the last one on the list is my favorite, that is shopping, because who doesn't love shopping? Now, both the cities definitely win for me when it comes to shopping because you get cheap stuffs here as well as in Mumbai, like Bakaswe Fashion Street, etc. in Mumbai. And if you're a shopaholic and you want to visit the places, then Commercial Street, Chick Pit are definitely a good place to visit, where you get cheap stuffs from jewelry to clothes to household items. So you would get everything at cheap price. So yeah, both the cities are definitely a win for me. Now, if you're planning to visit Bengaluru, then make sure you have this list of places on your list because those are a must visit. Now, if you love greenery, then Lal Bagh, Cobbin Park, etc. are definitely a must visit. And if you're interested in science or aeronautics or space, etc., then you should definitely visit the Visveshwara Industrial Museum, the HAL Aeronautics Space Museum. I'll definitely post few pictures over here so that you get an idea about it. And you can also visit the Nandi Hills, Bengaluru Palace and Mysore. Now, one interesting thing that I like about Bengaluru is the structure of the temples here. And every temple has a different architecture. And if you're planning to visit Mumbai, then make sure you check out these places. Like Marine Drive, Hanging Garden, and if you need to visit a temple, then Siddhivinayak, Haji Ali, Mahalakshmi are the best places to visit. And if you're an art person like me, then Jahangir Art Gallery is a must visit for you. You can also visit the Jawaharlal Nehru Planetarium and also the Elephanta Caves. I have been to Bengaluru a couple of times. And I must say that it was a love at first sight for me because of its climate and the greenery that it has got and the huge roads. But Mumbai to Mumbai hai and you just can't miss the vada pav. Like beyond all those rush hours and the pathetic climate that Mumbai has got, there is still a sense of belonging, a mass that shares the pain together. It's a city that grows in you. And it never lets you down, and that is why it is called as the dream city. The city never sleeps. Was that emotional? Anyways, so here's a wrap up, and if you guys like this video, then give this video a huge thumbs up and hit the subscribe button and the bell notification so that you are notified whenever I post a new video. Also, let me know in the comment section below which is your favorite city and which city you would like to visit. So stay connected. Bye. Bye. Bye.